Unreal Engine 5 offers three lighting methods, each suited for different needs, balancing realism and performance. You can illuminate an environment using Lumen, Bake Lighting or Path Tracing. In this video, I'll provide a brief overview of these methods, highlighting their advantages and disadvantages, as well as the best use cases for each of them. The first method I'll talk about is Baked Lighting, which is a pre-computed lighting method that stores light and shadow information in textures called lightmaps. This technique is widely used in architectural visualization, mobile games, and projects where performance optimization is crucial and lighting does not need to change dynamically. It provides high-quality, noise-free global illumination at a lower performance cost compared to Lumen. The lighting is calculated in advance using light masks, which simulate light bounces and shadows before rendering. Once baked, the lighting data is stored, meaning objects cannot dynamically react to lighting changes unless we rebake the lighting. It requires careful UV unwrapping and lightmap resolution adjustments to avoid artifacts and ensure smooth lighting. Unreal Engine does a great job with auto-unwrapping imported models, but sometimes the results are not great, especially for objects like sofas or blankets. If you buy models online though, they typically come with unwrap already. If that is the case, you just need to import them to Unreal with the original UV. Even though it doesn't adapt in real time, it's still an efficient way to get realistic, high-quality lighting without much performance hit. Next, the Lumen. It was introduced first in Unreal Engine 5, and now it's activated by default. The best thing about Lumen is that it provides real-time global illumination. It means that it gives us fully dynamic bounce lighting without the need for any pre-computed light maps. This allows for instant lighting updates when objects, light sources, or environments change. It's super helpful during the production process, but it comes with some drawbacks. Lumen comes at a price. It needs a strong GPU to run smoothly, and weaker systems will have a hard time keeping up. Lumen can sometimes cause flickering, ghosting, or noisy reflections, especially in mirrors. If you're going for high-quality renders, this is a big issue. Since it's an approximate method, small details and complex objects might not get super accurate in direct lighting, which can cause some lighting to look a bit off. Lumen isn't the best fit for VR since it needs a lot of GPU power, and it really relies on high frame rate to stay smooth. I will show you how Lumen can be effectively used in arch-viz workflow later. The third method is path tracing, which is a physically accurate rendering method designed for cinematic quality lighting and reflections. Unlike real-time methods like Lumen or baked lighting, path tracing simulates real-world light behavior by tracing multiple light bounces for a highly realistic global illumination, reflections, and shadows. It basically renders each frame like V-Ray would, for example. What's the point, you may ask? While it's too computationally expensive for real-time gameplay, it's an excellent choice for high-end architectural visualizations or animation. A common approach is to utilize Lumen for test renders and drafts you send to your clients, enabling fast, real-time animation of your scene. When it's time for final rendering, you can use path tracing to achieve the highest quality. Path tracing can be a great debugging tool as well. If you notice any weird results with Lumen or baked lighting, try switching to path tracing to get the most accurate look of your scene. Now, if you're looking to expand your services, learn new skills, and stay competitive, join our Unreal Engine training, specifically designed for arch-viz artists and architects. It's available for pre-order now, so make sure you check out all the details on the website. We cover how to create animations, visualizations, and real-time interactive experiences step by step. But that's not all. The whole course contains over 120 lessons covering theory and practice. We start by explaining the first steps in Unreal Engine. Then we will cover the theory behind our 8-step system for perfect visualizations and animations, which applies to every 3D software. We will teach you all about lighting in Unreal. We prepared a separate module with over 20 lessons dedicated to greenery and landscaping. Another 24-lesson module is dedicated to creating an interactive 360 experience like this using blueprints. And finally, we'll explain how we did this animation. To ensure the smooth learning process, all the assets will be included in the course or available to download for free from the FAP. All of the furniture and textures were provided by Rewrote. Join now! Now, let's discuss all lighting methods to choose depending on the type of the project. I start with the workflow for creating arch-viz stills and animation. When starting the production process, Lumen is a great choice thanks to its instant visualization of global illumination, shadows and reflections. You can quickly adjust lighting setups and test different HDRIs, sun angles or interior lights before baking. It speeds up iteration time, as there is no need to rebake every time lighting changes. Lumen also reduces trial and errors in bake lighting setups, saving production time. Besides, baked lighting can cause some issues, like light leaks, for example. Lumen also helps spot and fix potential issues before baking, making sure everything turns out just right. I would also use Lumen when working with clients. It makes working with them way easier. With traditional workflow with Corona and V-Ray, you would have to render the clay preview first to showcase the composition and camera movement. Then, you would probably render every few frames to present the materials, lighting and details. And finally, render the whole animation, hoping there will be no flickering issues or technical mistakes. By providing a real-time interactive experience, you can save a lot of time on reviews or meetings, clients can suggest changes on the fly, and you can adjust lights, materials or object placements in real-time without waiting for rebakes. And even if you don't meet with the client, you can still send over a render made with Lumen for a review, and then just use bake lighting for final delivery. If the high quality is important to you and your client, then using the path tracing instead of the light baking method for the final rendering will be the way to go. The workflow here will be similar, just the final method will differ. So you would use Lumen all the way, maybe switching to path tracing from time to time, just for testing. And at the end, render with path tracing, occasionally adjusting some post-production settings or material for the best output. When creating an interactive 360 experience in Unreal Engine, on the other hand, the choice between Lumen and bake lighting depends on your project's needs. Lumen is ideal for dynamic environments, where lighting changes based on user interaction. For example, if we need time of day adjustments or material changes. If high-quality global illumination and reflections are required, Lumen is a choice because it provides real-time indirect lighting, making interiors and exteriors look more natural. Also, if you need fast iteration and flexibility, no need to manually bake lighting, allowing you to make quick design changes without long processing times. Choose bake lighting, on the other hand, when performance is a priority. Pre-computed lighting is much lighter on performance, making it suitable for VR and mobile experiences where real-time GI is too expensive. It also works well with static environments. If your scene has no dynamic lighting changes, baked lighting can provide clean, noise-free results at a lower cost. And finally, if you need an ultra-smooth performance in large-scale projects, baked lighting will be a better choice. If your experience has many light sources and complex shading, you can benefit from efficiency of baked lighting. So to sum up, for desktop-based 360 experiences, Lumen is a great choice for immersive realism. However, for VR or mobile, baked lighting is often the best option to maintain high frame rates and smooth performance. If you want to learn how to use those methods in practice step by step, join our Unreal Engine course. You can also stay here on YouTube and watch more videos. Bye-bye!